Hi guys, I'm Styx Audio Video Production. Today I'm gonna present you the new tool from iStop. It's called Audio Lens and it's really useful to match mastering from any kind of producer you want. So today I want to show you how to use Audio Lens for your recording, your mixing and mastering purpose. Let me say, you can use this tool in different ways. For example, you can match the curve, so the EQ curve of another song, so already released song from famous producer, famous singer. But you can also copy only instruments, so for example, the intro of a metal guitar, maybe a guitar that is, let me say, that sound like a phone, like a telephone, like a megaphone, so only really high frequencies, mid focused. You can match that curve and you can use the Audio Lens in other iZotope plugin, because the really cool thing about this Audio Lens is that you can use it in the ecosystem of iZotope. So you can use with Ozone and you can use with Neuron. Today I want to show you how to use inside Ozone. So before jump and start the review about Audio Lens, I want to say that Audio Lens is a really great tool in my opinion for two reasons. One, because you can use inside the ecosystem of iZotope. So if you already have some iZotope, for example, Ozone and Neuron, you can use the Audio Lens for free, because basically you can use inside a plugin that you already have. Keep in mind that Audio Lens has to be used or in Ozone or in Neuron. I don't know if you can use also in other plugin, but you cannot use standalone without any other plugin, because Audio Lens will not record any sound. Audio Lens will analyze the sound and will create a curve with dynamic, with loudness, all this kind of information. Will not record anything, okay? So you need another plugin, for example, again, Ozone 10 or Neuron, to use this information in your mixing and mastering, okay? Pay attention to this. And secondly, why I really like this plugin is that you can basically steal the tone from every kind of source you want without make any routing. So this is really important. You can play Spotify, you can play iTunes, Apple Music, Tidal, whatever kind of streaming platform, YouTube, without make any routing to make Audio Lens listen the sound. Whatever kind of streaming you play, Audio Lens will listen, okay? This is really great. I think there are some routing inside Audio Lens to listen basically whatever kind of thing you play in your PC. This is extremely useful and extremely time-saving. This is really important. So I really like this idea of iZotope to make everything really simple. So you have only to launch Audio Lens, click, listen, and you're good to go. So before jump into Audio Lens, I want to say that today I let you listen probably some copyright music. I have to show you how to use Audio Lens, and probably this video will be demonetized because of this reason. So if you want to really support me and support this video, you have a send a super thanks button down below and you can support this video. If you really like my content and want to see more and you want to suggest me something and I can prepare a video dedicated to you, you have the join button. You can join my YouTube channel, becoming a member. You can get really great benefits, download guitar presets, impulse response, DAW templates, and are already available if you join my YouTube channel. So let's jump into the Audio Lens. As you can see here, Audio Lens is really simple. Basically, you have nothing. You have only this capture tab. And basically what you have to do is to play something, okay? So let's play something. Let me say, I've here in my Studio One 6 session, three different songs, and I try to keep three different songs with three different genres. So the first is an acoustic, pure acoustic. Okay, the second is an R&B song. And lastly is my song, actually, is a metal instrument song, okay? Okay, these are the three songs that I've selected to show you how Audiolens work. Now, let's go back to Audiolens, and now we have to play something. So, today is really easy for me to use Spotify, and let me also use my headphones because I can listen better. So let's use Spotify, and let me say, for acoustic, I really know an album from Massimo Varini. He's an Italian, really great acoustic guitar man. And for example, I really like a song which is from the Anacrusis album, and it's Our Life, this one. It's really rich of bass, the clarity of the guitar. I really like the master of this album. So let's play this. Let's go here. As you can see, we have the curve that it's moving. Now let's click capture. It's listening right now. You can keep listening for 10 seconds because this is a curve that is moving. So you are recording also the dynamic, the loudness, not only an EQ, okay? Okay, stop. And I can also go here on target and place, for example, acoustic Varini reference, okay? Save. And I can also stop playing. I can go here again. And as you can see, I have this curve. But this curve, as you can see, is not static. And where you can see, maybe here, the curve has this thick piece of violet color. This is basically where you have the dynamic. So it's telling me that here, basically, the bass goes from a minimum of here and maximum of here. So this is the dynamic curve, okay? So this is basically the tolerance that it's recording. This is really important because you have to use this shape, this tolerance in your mix and mastering. Okay, now let's record other curve, and then I'll move to Studio One. So now let's go back to Spotify, and according to my metal song, I can use, for example, something from metalcore, From Death to Death. This is the album that I really like. Let's play this. Okay. Let's capture. Okay, stop. And now I have my second curve. I have to place metalcore asking. Okay, this is my second curve, and as you can see, it's totally different, the curve from previous to the second. Okay, now let's go to another song. My R&B song, I can choose something from maybe Eminem. Okay. And I remember the song Love the Way You Lie with Rihanna. Just gonna stand there. Okay, maybe something. That's all right, because the day is over, it's a different day. Sound like broken records playing over, but you promised them. Okay. Next time you show restraint, you don't get another chance. Like there's no Nintendo game, but you lie to game. Capture. Now you get to watch her leave out the window. Guess that's why they call it window pane. Just gonna stand there and watch me burn. But that's alright, because I like the way it hurts. Just gonna actually, I think it's lacking of some bass here, as you can see, but let's try anyway. Now we can close Audiolens, because Audiolens is only listening something, okay? It's not doing anything on the audio. So let's close it. Now let's go to Studio 1.6, and as you can see here, I've opened the instance of Ozone 10, one per each song. So now let's go here to the acoustic song. Let's go on the Ozone 10, and I already done a video about the Ozone 10, how to use it with the new assistant here, new artificial intelligence. If you want to see the video dedicated to this, you have the link in the corner. Basically, you have to make learn something. So go to relearn and let's play. So now basically Ozone is analyzing all the song and create the FX chain for the mastering. Okay, and this is the curve that has been created, as you can see. Now I want to apply my curve because I want that this will sound more matched to my Massimo Varini album, okay? So we can go here and we can see all the matching curve that we did in the AudioLens. So let's click on acoustic reference. He is again building a new mastering FX chain to get that curve, that dynamic. As you can see, this is the curve that we captured with the AudioLens. Let's play again. And we can also decide the amount of the curve to apply, maybe 0. Let's bypass. This is my song without any mastering. This is my song with all the cue master. Let's play in the middle. And this is matching basically the master of my capture album sound. Really, really great. You can use this also as a starting point and also to learn how you can master different song, okay? Now let's move to the R&B song. Okay, so normally we have this Ozone artificial intelligence that it creates basically the FX chain with the hip-hop rap curve and other stuff. If you can see inside here, there are a lot of stuff, okay? And let's listen how it sounds with only Ozone. Okay, now let's apply the curve of Eminem and Rihanna from that song, okay? And let's see how it sounds and how it changes also the sound. Remember that here there is some lack on the bass, as I told you. Let's listen. There is much more clarity. Life is a jet plane, travels too fast, burning bridges, can't go back. Wish that I could press replay and edit some of my mistakes. Bypassed. Only gonna live it once, so got myself some extra fame. Ninja go because I wanted a piece, but I got to squeeze voluptuous cheeks. Pretty and loud when you open your mouth, hotter than lava just pouring around. You gave me feeling, you were my gift, you were my boo, you were my fix. No, but I know it's too late, living my life in the faster lane. Give me a chance, give me a shot, let me explain just what we got. Games will be over with a revival, I'ma be a lover, never your rival. I'll give you no lies, no reason. I prefer. I'll give you my heart, I'll give you the keys. I'll give you forever until I stop breathing, because you, I believe in. Didn't we bring it? Didn't we live it? Didn't we ride it till it was over? Don't tell me that. If we go again back. Yes, I prefer with much more bass. Let's go now to my metal song. So this is my metal song. Let's go on this portion. Let's apply now the curve of the Asking Alexandria song, and let's listen how it behaves. Okay, as you can see, this is the curve. This is before, this is the after. You can listen that here, basically on this portion is much more open the sound because there are some mids. And then of course you can change everything, because you can go here inside, you can see the FX chain, and basically, as you can see, there is some post EQ. You can adjust everything you want, if you want more bass, more mid, more highs. So this is really interesting, in my opinion, to steal the curve and dynamic from already released song and to understand how to mix and how to master, because basically Audiolens is, again, is not recording any song, okay? It's not recording any audio, because of course are copyright audio, so you cannot record audio and use audio in your system, so don't do that, it's really illegal, guys. So Audiolens is a really great tool, really helpful to understand the dynamic, the loudness, and the overall EQ of already released mastering songs, and to compare basically your mix and master and try to achieve the same level. Okay, guys, you have the link in the description if you want to try the Audiolens, and until the 22 of November of 2022, maybe you are seeing this video later, but is free, guys. You can download for free until the 22 of November. So guys, leave a comment below, let me know what you think about, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.